We see a number of patients who come to us who have achy joints and inflammation. And it's quite surprising and interesting when they start on natural bioidentical hormones and the correct herbs that help to make those hormones work properly, and a healthier diet, of course, and they start noticing for the first time the aches and pains start going away. Do you think there's a correlation between, say, testosterone at optimum levels and balancing and clearing the excess estrogens and maybe balancing out the cortisol and adrenals and even thyroid, you mentioned, and growth hormone? Do you think that might play a role in the inflammation and achy joints that many people complain of?
Absolutely. Again, why are achy joints? It's because of inflammation. Hormonal decline as aging, and a lot of the old age diseases are really inflammatory diseases. And is it, even depression is an inflammatory state. We know that interleukin beta increases. So patients, even after heart attacks, why do they get more depressed? Heart disease, cardiovascular disease, is an inflammatory state. We also know that depression is an inflammatory state. It's natural. Then, of course, arthritis is an inflammatory state. So it's almost like the body is not just separated. It's not compartmentalized. It's a web. So you've got inflammation in one system, you're going to have an outpouring of inflammation. So what hormones do is that as hormone decline occurs, there's increased inflammation. So if you restore the hormone balance and you restore, again, some of the biochemical reactions that the body needs to do through either the herbs or the nutrients, or what we call, you know, nutrigenomic substances, a concoction of the herbs, vitamins, certain key minerals that have been studied that can affect hormones and certain key aspects of what I believe is a mitochondria optimization, then we see a much better result. We see arthritis come down. We may even see regression of plaque in arteries. So it's a continuum. We see so many benefits. It's not just, and really when you look at the stroke, when you look at diabetes, when you look at bone osteoporosis, and when you look at heart disease, all of these, or arthritis, all of these are really, the basis is the inflammation. And the basis is the decline again of the hormones.